God, you are me everything. You make me feel magnificent. To you, me give all the praise. Oh, Jah.
Welcome to Mother's Eve Girls. This is Sean Gnosis. Today, I'm going to give you a brief overview of all why I grow the American apple rootstocks for my upcoming backyard orchard. Stay tuned. To germinate apple seeds, we use a process called stratification. This is where apple seeds are stored in the fridge under damp conditions for a few weeks. No, when it comes to any crop, soil is very important. This soil specifically was obtained from the Rio Kobe River. It's a mixture of sand and clay, a perfect balance for retaining moisture, but at the same time providing adequate drainage. As you can see, it's very rich and very fertile. For me personally, I like to organize my apple seeds in this container. I only store seeds obtained from Gala, a very common and popular apple variety throughout the world. For this container, I only store the variety called Pink Lady. Now, in the past, I used to use party plastic cups, but I soon realized that after a couple of weeks, they began to start to break down in direct sunlight. So I started to use these, and so far, so good. Now, after filling each container with dirt, I typically use a screwdriver to help assist with making a hole for the seeds. Now, when I'm planting my seeds, I like to ensure that each sprout has at least 1.5 inches. For me, it guarantees between 80 to 90% of success rates. After planting them, I typically add a few drops of water. Now, welcome to my apple tree nursery. Typically, after they outgrow their small containers previously, I tend to transplant them into seedling bags. As you can see, I'm trying to pick which one I'm going to plant out in my upcoming backyard orchard. As you can see, there are quite a few. In the future, I'll be showing you how I set up my irrigation system for my apple tree nursery. Most of these apple tree saplings are between 6 to 9 months old. So I carefully remove the seedling bags and gradually loosen the dirt around the side, so as to give the roots some chance after transplanting to breed and extend. I recommend digging a hole between 2 feet deep and 2 feet wide. After you finish digging a hole, you want to add back the dirt at least up to 1/4 inches, leaving space to plant your saplings. If you observe closely, my spacing between my trees are exactly 2.5 feet. This is known as high density gardening. And in the future, I'll be showing you step by step how to set up an high-density gardening orchard in your own backyard. As you can see, I'm gradually adding back the dirt that I digged earlier. The reason for doing this is that the soil is now loose, which in turn enables the trees to establish more better, because the roots can easily go through the soil without any problem. And that's perfectly right at the ground level. I'm gradually just loosening the soil right around the edges to expose the roots to the new dirt. And then I just gradually add the last layer of dirt. If you observe closely, both apple saplings are planted against a support system. In the future, I'll be making a step-by-step guide on how to build your own apple orchard support system. As a bonus, I added a small amount of NPK fertilizer to reduce transplant shock.
Trying to keep the love high. All the good people wave with a smile. Trying.